Hello, my dear students. I am Vishwanath Sharma, assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about one of the important topic in discrete mathematical structures, that is mathematical logic. In the first unit, you have studied about set theory and combinatorics. Now, in the second unit, we are going to study about mathematical logic. In our introductory class, we discussed the importance of mathematical logic in discrete mathematics. So, the importance of mathematical logic is where we can use this in designing a knowledge base of an intelligent system. A knowledge base is an important component of an intelligent system in artificial intelligence. So to design a knowledge base, how do we design that? The first question, and what the knowledge base consists of? How do we embed the information into the knowledge base? Generally, the knowledge base of an intelligent system consists of huge information, and this information will be stored in the form of the statements or sentences, which we cannot store the statements or sentences in the form of our natural language. We need to store it in the form of machine language so that the machine can understand and gives the output to the given input. So how do we store the information in the form of machine language? So to know that, we need to discuss about what is mathematical logic. So first try to understand what is mathematical logic, what is logic, and then what are the classifications of mathematical logic. Let us start the lecture. So mathematical logic, the definition of mathematical, the main subject of mathematical logic is mathematical proof. So what is the meaning of this? So we need to prove the given set of sentences. We need to prove the given set of a sentence which is valid or not from the given set of sentences. That means that you will be given sentences S1, S2, S3, S4, all these. These sentences may be simple sentences, these sentences may be complex sentences. Whatever the sentence will be given, that using these sentences, you need to check that whether P is proved or not. That means whether it will be derivable or not from the given set of sentences. So to prove such thing, what we need to do, we need to apply mathematical proof. There we can use mathematical logic. So this is the mathematical logic. Now coming to the next point, this mathematical logic basically evolving around the notations of logical validity. What is logical validity? Logical validity, provability, and computation. These are the three important terms which we used here. The entire mathematical logic evolving around about these three notations. Validity is nothing but when you have given a set of sentences, like just now we discussed S1, S2 and so on. Suppose I have two sentences. Using these two sentences, I need to prove that whether P is provable or not. If it is provable, then it is called probability and validity. Validity is nothing but if all the sentences are true and the given conclusion will also be true, then we say that it is called a valid sentence. And computation. Computation is nothing but how do we derive or how do we prove or how do we check the given sentence P is valid or is it is provable from the given set of sentences. Whether these two sentences are enough to prove that the given sentence P is valid or not, or these two sentences are not enough, and still we need to derive some more sentences from the given set of sentences to check that whether it is true or not. That is what the computation, what we are going to do in this mathematical logic. So how do we do that? We'll discuss in the further classes. Basically, the mathematical logic evolving around these three notations, the applications of the mathematical logic is very, very important. That is called theory of inference, where we can prove the given sentence from the given set of sentences. That means we need to check the sentence whether it is valid or not from the given set of sentences. How do we check it? We'll discuss in the further classes. Now, before going to discuss about what are the classifications of mathematical logic, let us try to understand what do you mean by a logic. It is a way to improve one's critical thinking skills. Logic is a way of, it is a way to improve what? Critical thinking skills. Why it is? Because when a problem is given to you, for example, a problem is given to you, what you are going to do? You are going to think about that, how to solve the problem. So you are going to think about that, how to go solve the problem. That means what? You are trying to apply your reasoning process to solve a particular problem. How do you apply your reasoning process? What are the methods which are available to solve this particular problem? What are the different methods which are available to solve this particular problem? So that is what. See, you are going to think about like this, whether I have to follow this particular procedure in this direction so that I will get what? Whether I will get the solution or not. Suppose if I, can I follow this particular procedure so that I will get a solution in this. Like that, you have different procedure, which procedure I have to apply so that I will get a solution to the given particular problem. So how do we do that? So by applying your reasoning process, by applying your thinking process, you are going to do that. So that's why logic, what it is, a way to improve your thinking skills, critical thinking skills. Studying the problem and implementing strategies to find a solution to the given problem. That is what basically, this is the how we are trying to improve our thinking skills, or which method we have to apply and what the method consists of. What is the procedure for that method? How do I solve the problem? So these are the way you are going to think to solve a particular problem. So by which your thinking process or your reasoning process will develop to solve a particular problem. So this is what we can call it as a logic. The general, the most important definition of the logic is nothing but analysis of methods of reasoning. It is nothing but, just I am writing here, analysis of, the another way to define it is analysis of methods of reasoning. This is what I said. So this is the most important definition of a logic. And not only that, logic is a language of the computer science. It is very important. Every language, like our natural language, which consists of syntax and semantics, in the similar way, logic also consists of syntax and semantics. So basically, syntax, what it will give you? It will give you how to construct a statement or how to write a statement by using certain rules. So if you cannot follow those certain rules, what will happen? You will get a syntactical error. So because, as we know that a sequence of words is called a syntax, is called a sentence or a statement. So a statement can be written in any form. So you can use the rules of syntax of the given language and write the statement. Once you are going to write a statement, you need to check that whether that statement has a proper meaning or not. How do we check it? To check that, we need to go for semantics. So syntax will give you how to write a statement, and semantics will give you the proper meaning of a statement. Because you can make the statement by using sequence of words, every statement may not give you proper meaning. Only few sentences will give you proper meaning. How do we know that? So you need to follow the semantics of what? That particular language. In the similar way, this logic or mathematical logic, why it is called mathematical logic? To solve a problem, what are the procedures or what are the methods which we are going to apply? All these methods will be represented in the form of mathematics. So that's why this logic is called what? Mathematical logic. Now we'll try to discuss about what are the different classifications of mathematical logic. So categories of mathematical logic. Mathematical logic can be classified into two types. The first one is called the propositional logic. The first one is the propositional logic. This is the one of the important logic which we are going to discuss first, and then we are going to discuss about the second one is predicate logic. Why we need to go for predicate logic? Already we have a propositional logic. What is the importance of this predicate logic? Because this particular propositional logic, whatever the first classification of the mathematical logic, has some limitations. The syntax of that particular propositional logic does not allow us to convert every sentence into the form of propositional language. Because of that, we need to go for predicate logic. Predicate logic will allow us every sentence of English language can be converted into the form of what? In that particular language. So we'll discuss first what is propositional logic, what is the syntax of the propositional logic, and what are the semantics of the propositional logic. Then we can go for predicate logic. Now coming to the propositional logic. In this particular propositional logic, we are going to discuss about certain topics. What are those? The first one is statements and notations. In the statements and notations, what we are trying to do, which gives you the syntax of the propositional logic. Generally, propositional language consists of what type of statements or what type of sentences? And or how do we represent each sentence in the form of propositional logic? What are the different notations? That is what we are trying to discuss here. And coming to the connectivities, if you want to connect different sentences to make a complex sentence, and what type of connectivities are required, and what are the important connectivities in propositional logic, and they are also called logical connectivities. We are trying to discuss about what is logical connectivity. Well-formed formula. Just now I said that every language consists of what? Syntax and semantics. Semantics will give you the proper meaning of a sentence. We'll check that whether the sentence has a proper meaning or not. So if it has a proper meaning in propositional language form, what we can call it as a well-defined formula. How we are going to say that the given formula is a well-defined formula? Generally, every sentence what we are going to take, or the complex sentences, we call it as a formula. And that formula, when you say that it is a well-defined, means what? Whether a proper meaning or not of that particular formula. So how do we check it? That is what we are going to discuss in this. Next, truth table. What is a truth table and why it is important in propositional logic? How do we construct the truth tables? All these things which we are going to discuss in this. Logical equivalence. So once we discussed about the truth table, then we can go for the logical equivalence. Because it is not possible to construct a truth table for all the given complex sentences. We'll shortly define what is a complex sentence. Complex sentence is nothing but combination of all the sentences is called a complex sentence. When you have a huge number of sentences, each sentence can be represented in the form of preposition. If it is in the form of preposition, then by using the truth table, it is not possible to construct a truth table. We'll discuss what are the limitations of the truth table and why should we go for logical equivalences. And then tautological implications, normal forms, and finally theory of inference for statement calculus. This is very, very important, which is an application of propositional logic. So how do, as in our, just now we discussed about that, the definition of mathematical, the main important subject of mathematical logic is that a mathematical proof. So how do we do that? Mathematically, how we are going to prove that a sentence is a valid sentence from the given set of sentences? To do that, you should know about what do you mean by theory of inference. So first, what is inference? What are the different inference laws? And how do we apply these laws to prove that the given sentence is a valid sentence from the given set of sentences? We will discuss in this, which is very, very important. So these are the important topics which we are going to discuss in propositional logic. In this particular lecture, I am going to deliver especially the syntax of the propositional logic and the semantics of the propositional logic. First, we try to understand these two and then we can go for other topics. Coming to the propositional logic, what is the definition of propositional logic? A propositional logic is a mathematical system, for what? Reasoning. About what? Propositions. It is a mathematical system for what? For reasoning process. About what? About propositions. And how they related to one another. It is a mathematical system. Why it is a mathematical system? Propositional logic is a logic of what? Mathematical logic. So it is one of the important languages. So that's why it is a mathematical language or a mathematical system. That means an intelligent, the knowledge base of an intelligent system is designed by a propositional logic. Such a system, what we can call it as a mathematical system, because the information which we are going to embed into the knowledge base, that will be in the form of propositional logic, and it is a mathematical form. So therefore it is a mathematical system. For what? For reasoning process. And about propositions, what do you mean by proposition? What is a proposition? The definition of proposition tells us that a statement which is either true or false. A statement which is true, either true or false, it is called a proposition. That means that when you take any statement, suppose for example, it is a rainy day today. It is a rainy day today. Suppose I am taking the sentence. If it is a rainy day, we can say that this sentence is a true. Or if it is not rainy day, if it is hot today, then we can go with what? False. So a proposition is a statement which can be either true or false. That is what? Proposition. So example is, it is a rainy day. It may be true or it may be false. And how these propositions are related to one another? One proposition is related to another proposition, or how do we combine these propositions? These are the things which we are going to discuss. So this is the basic definition of a propositional logic. As I said earlier, it is a simple language which consists of propositional symbols and logical connectivities. What is propositional symbol, or what is a propositional variable? We will discuss. And why we need logical connectivity. what is the importance of logical connectivity, or what are the different types of logical connectivities in propositional logic. A proposition is a statement by itself, either true or false. Just now I defined and I said that what is a proposition. Here I have given few examples. What are the Usain Bolt can outrun everyone in this room. This sentence may be true or this sentence may be false. This place about to blow. It may be true or it may be false. That depending upon the situation you are going to take, whether it is a true or whether it is a false. So remember that every statement or is a, whether every statement will be a proposition or not. That is the first thing. If it is a proposition, that statement generally consists of two truth values. One is called true, another one is called what? False. Sometimes we are going to take that statement is true, and sometimes we are going to take that statement is false. So that is what a proposition. Whether every statement is a proposition or not, that is the next question. Whether every statement will be a proposition or not, there are some sentences which we cannot treat them as propositions, that is things that are not propositions. The first one is commands. So whatever the commands we are going to use in the language, these commands, you cannot say that whether the command will be true or whether the command will be false. Suppose print, scanf, these are the commands which we can use. All these are not whether true or false, you cannot say that. So therefore, commands cannot be true or false, and they cannot be treated as propositions. Next one is questions. Cannot be true or false. Why? What? How? If the questions will be given like this, you cannot say that whether it is a true or whether it is a false. Any question, we cannot decide whether it is a true or whether it is a false. So therefore, questions cannot be treated as what? Propositions. Another important thing is that if you observe this particular slide, here in this slide, what will happen? It consists of two sentences here. This is the first sentence, and if you observe that, this is the second sentence. This is a combination of, this is the given entire sentence. And this sentence consists of two sentences. This is a first sentence and this is a second sentence. And the first sentence is, I am the walrus. Means I am something, I am a boy, I am a girl. It may be true or it may be true. So the first sentence is a valid sentence, valid proposition, because it takes any one of the truth value. Either it may be true or it may be false. But go, go, go job. See, gibberish cannot be true or false. That means if the sentence will be given in the form of like this, such sentences, what we can call them as gibberish. So if this entire sentence, if you consider that the first sentence is a valid proposition, but the second sentence is not a proposition, you cannot assign any truth value for the second sentence. In that case, the entire sentence, if you consider, this sentence is not a proposition. One sentence is a proposition and another sentence is not a proposition. If you combine these two sentences, then the entire sentence is not a proposition. Remember, this is very, very important. So these are some of the examples which are not propositions. Commands cannot be propositions. Questions cannot be propositions. And the third one is, if one sentence is a proposition and the second sentence is not a proposition, then the entire sentence is not a proposition. Why? Because if one sentence is a proposition, you can assign the truth value. Suppose this is true. Let us assume that the first sentence is true. And what is the second sentence? Here you don't know which value to assign it, because it doesn't have any truth value. Then if you take the combined sentence of this, then how do you assign the truth value for this combined sentence? It is not possible to assign a truth value for the combined sentence because of the second sentence. It does not take any truth value. In such case, it is not a proposition, because by definition, proposition must be either true or it must be either false. So it will not give you any truth value of this sentence, therefore it is not a proposition. So now coming to the syntax of the propositional logic. What is the syntax? Because syntax of any language tells us that how to write the statements, how to construct the statements, and what are the rules which we need to follow to write the statements. In the similar way, propositional logic is also one type of language. This language consists of some set of statements, and how do we write these statements in the form of propositional logic. That is what we are trying to discuss in syntax of propositional logic. Now coming to the syntax of the propositional logic, this syntax consists of two important sentences. The first one is called the atomic sentence, and the second one is called complex sentence. The syntax of propositional logic allows two types of sentences. One is atomic, another one is complex. Let us define what is atomic sentence. Coming to the atomic sentence, it is a simple sentence. It is a simple sentence which is either true or false, or any single sentence is called an atomic sentence. Just now I said it is a rainy day. Suppose if you take an example like this, it is a rainy day. Today, if I am going to take a sentence like this, it is one sentence or a single sentence or a simple sentence. This sentence generally what we can call it as a atomic sentence. In the previous case I said this place is about to blow. It may be true or false, we don't know, but it is a single sentence, therefore it is called a atomic sentence. So this is atomic sentences are simple sentences, or they are single sentences which consist of either true value or false value. So this is what generally atomic sentences are represented by, like this, capital letters. It consists of a true value, false value, and it is represented by capital letters like this. In some textbooks, they may be represented with small letters also. Generally, why we need to represent? Just now I said, it is a rainy day. Suppose it is a rainy day. If you take the sentence, this is. Instead of writing every time this sentence as it is a rainy day, it is a rainy day, wherever we are going to use, what we need to do, we need to represent with one variable. Such a variable, generally what we can call it as a propositional variable. This is called propositional variable. Why? Because this variable will give you what? A truth value of the given sentence, whether it is a true or false. So a statement, an atomic sentence is represented by a variable. That variable generally we can call it as a propositional variable. So that is what it is represented with, P, Q, R. In some textbooks it may be represented with like this, small letters also, P, Q, R. Anyway you can take the representation. Coming to the complex sentence. A complex sentence, what is complex sentence? A complex sentence is a combination of atomic sentences. That means you need to take the combination of two or more atomic sentences which will give you a complex sentence. So this is the one sentence, and this is the one sentence, and this is the another sentence which we combined with. Here it is given something. What is that? How do we combine that sentence? How do we combine these two atomic sentences? So to combine the atomic sentences in propositional logic, we use the connectivity. By using that connectivity, you can combine what? Two or more atomic sentences. So such a connectivity, generally what we can call it as a logical connectivity. So that is the definition of a logical connectivity. A logical connectivity is a connectivity, or it is a symbol which try to convert two or more atomic sentences. That is called a logical connectivity. So now suppose, suppose if I can take P is the one sentence, suppose P is, it is a rainy day. Simply I am taking, every time I am taking, this is an, it is a rainy day. Q is that I will not go to school, I will not go to college. Suppose individually these are the two sentences. I want to combine these two sentences to get a one sentence. How do I combine? So to combine these sentences, as I said, I am going to use a logical connectivity like this. P implies Q. So that means I want to convert, I want to write a combined sentence like this. If it is a rainy day, then I will not go to college. I want to combine like this. If it is a rainy day today, then I will not go to college. How do I represent this sentence in the form of prepositional logic? It will be represented in the form of P implies Q. We will discuss what is this implies in the next slide. So this is basically a complex sentence. Remember that atomic sentence is a single sentence and complex sentence is a what? Combination of two or more atomic sentences. How do we combine these atomic sentences? These atomic sentences are combined by a logical connectivity. Such a connectivity we can call it as a logical connectivity. Logical connectivities. To combine two or more sentences, we use a connectivity. Such a connectivity generally we can call it as a logical connectivity. So that is the basic definition of a logical connectivity, and this logical connectivity is also called as sentential connectivity, or also called it as a propositional connectivity. Just now I have defined the sentence. Logical connectivity is a symbol or a word used to connect two or more sentences in grammatically valid way. So it is connect two or more sentences. It is a symbol or word connecting two or more sentences which are grammatically valid. So grammatically valid is nothing but, suppose when you take a proposition P, if P is a proposition, a variable, then it consists of a true value. Suppose if it consists of a true value and Q is the another proposition variable, suppose if it consists of a false, then if you connect P and Q, it will give you, because this will give you the truth value, this will give you the truth value. When you combine the sentences by using logical connectivity, definitely you will get a some truth value. Then we can say that it is a grammatically valid. If you combine the sentences, that combination we are, how we are going to combine, we will discuss. Generally we use different connectivities. One connectivity is called conjunction. This is called a conjunction. Then if you combine the sentence like this, definitely it will give a truth value, either true or false. Then we can say that this sentence is grammatically valid because it is giving a truth value. In the previous slides, we discussed about a proposition, things that are not propositions. One sentence will give you the truth value. Suppose this will give you the truth value. And if it is not giving any truth value, this is giving the truth value, but this sentence is not giving the truth value, then this entire sentence, what happened, will not give you the truth value. In that case, it is not a proposition. So grammatically valid is nothing but when you combine the two sentences, that combination of two or more sentences is called a complex sentence. That sentence also will give you some truth value, either true or false. Then only we can say that it is grammatically valid in propositional logic. If one sentence will give you the truth value and the other sentence will not give you the truth value, if you combine those two sentences, that entire sentence will not give you any truth value. Then it is not a grammatically valid. So this is what about logical connectivities. So what are the different types of logical connectivities in propositional logic?
So these are the five important types of logical connectivities in propositional logic. The first one is called the conjunction. Here I have given the compound statement. Compound statement in the sense, when you have two statements like P and Q, we are going to combine these two sentences, P and Q. Conjunction. Whenever there is and, if it is a rainy day and I will not go to school. It is a rainy day and I will not go to school. This is the one sentence. It is a rainy day if you represent it with a propositional variable P, and I will not go to school if you represent with Q, because it is a rainy day and I will not go to school. These two sentences are combined by and, that is called conjunction. In that case, in propositional logic, we are going to write that entire statement as P and Q. In the similar way, or. So disjunction. This is or. Whenever there is or, either this or that. That is what? P or Q. In that case, we can use disjunction. Negation. Wherever you want to get the negativity of the sentence, when suppose I will go to school, that is represented with P. I will not go to school. How do we represent in propositional logic? To represent that, we need to use negation. So if this is P, I will go to school. The negation of P indicates what? I will not go to school. So this is how we can use the negation. Implication. If and then, when the sentence consists of if and then, if it is a rainy day today, then I will not go to school today. If the sentence is given like that, then how do we write it in propositional logic? There we can use implication. And then finally we can go for by implication. Wherever the condition, necessary and sufficient condition, if and only if condition is there you have to use by conditional or what? By implication. These are the five connectivities which we can use to convert every English sentence into the form of propositional logic, which are very, very important connectivities. So once you are going to connect the sentences by using this logical connectivity, you need to decide the truth value depending upon the individual truth values of each and every propositional variable. That means what? If P is Q, suppose P is Q, P is true, suppose P is true here, this is true, and given that this is false, then when you combine these two sentences, what will be the truth value? By combining with conjunction, what will be the truth value? By combining with disjunction, what will be the truth value? To know that, you should go for truth tables. Individually, you know that whether the statement is true or false, but when you combine all the sentences, two or more, suppose three sentences or four sentences, when you combine that, how do you know that entire sentence will consist of a particular truth value? That depends upon the connectivity, what we are going to use. Based on that connectivity, we try to tell this entire complex sentence has this particular truth value. So that's why connectivities plays very, very important role in propositional logic. Once you constructed a sentence, it may be a atomic sentence or it may be a complex sentence, then the next step, it is not only constructing or what, getting a sentence in propositional logic. You need to check that whether that sentence has a proper meaning or not. Why? Because in English language, suppose if you go with English language, let me give you one example. Suppose in English language, Rama is a boy. This is a sentence. It is a sequence of words. According to the English language, it follows the grammar. It has a proper meaning. Suppose if I can take the another one like this. Boy is a Rama. Or boy A is Rama. A boy Rama is. This is the statement one, this is the statement, another second statement, and this is the third statement, and this is the fourth statement. Of these four statements, according to the English grammar, suppose this give you the clear meaning. So it following the rules of this syntax. So it has a proper meaning, and everybody can understand what is the meaning of this sentence. Now coming to the boy is a Rama. You don't know. Boy A is Rama. What is the meaning of this sentence? A boy Rama. We don't know what is the meaning of this sentence, and we don't know what is the meaning of this sentence. You cannot exactly tell the meaning of these two sentences, and these sentences doesn't have any proper meaning. So even though we can constructed the sentences like these different sentences, of which only this particular sentence has a proper meaning. So that gives what the semantics of the logic or language. Syntax will give you the construction of a statement. I am constructing the statements, all are like this, but of all these statements, only one statement has a proper meaning. In the similar way, when you are going to construct the sentences in propositional logic, you need to check that whether that sentence has a proper meaning or not. If it will give you a proper meaning, what do you mean by the proper meaning? Suppose I am going to construct a sentence like this by using the logical connectivities P and Q or S implies T. So this is I have combined all the sentences what P, Q, S and T with three logical connectivities like this. P and Q or S implies T. What is the meaning of that sentence? So we cannot, whether the we can take P and Q or implies S and T, like this can we take, or P and Q or S implies T, or P and Q, suppose you can take like this, Q or S implies T. What is the mean? So how we are going to define this statement? Because you don't know what is the meaning of this particular sentence. If the sentence will be given like that, there is an ambiguity of getting the meaning. So whether I am going to take the sentence like this to get it, because individually suppose this is true, this is false, this is false, this is true. Assume that. Individually you know that every statement, the truth value of every statement. If I will give you a combined statement like this, how do you get the truth value of that particular sentence? Whether I have to take the statement like this, whether I have to go with like this, or I can go with like this to get a truth value, there is an ambiguity. In such case, it will not give you the proper meaning. In that case, what will happen? You will not get the proper truth value. So when you not only constructing a statement is not important in what propositional logic, it should give the proper meaning. So whenever it will give you a proper meaning in terms of propositional logic, whenever you will get a truth value for the given compound sentence or a complex sentence, then such a sentence, what we can call it as a well-defined sentence or a well-defined formula in propositional logic. I'm giving the summary of this particular lecture. We started with what is a mathematical logic, where we can use the mathematical logic. So before going to discuss about what exactly is a mathematical logic, it consists of two terms like mathematics and logic. So you define what is logic. We defined already what is logic. Why it is mathematical logic? Already we defined, because the language, logic is a language and it is represented in the form of mathematics. So therefore it is called a mathematical logic. And then we discussed about what are the classifications of this mathematical logic or categories of mathematical logic, like propositional logic and predicate logic. We started with propositional logic first. We discussed syntax of the, what do you mean by a proposition? A proposition is a variable which is either true or false. So what is the syntax of the propositional logic? Basically, syntax of propositional logic consists of two sentences, atomic sentence and complex sentence. We define what are they. When you combine the sentences, how do we get the truth value? We discussed about that also. And then we discuss about finally what logical connectivity is and semantics of propositional logic. Semantics will connect two or more sentences in grammatically valid way. That is called a logical connectivity. Once you can construct a sentence to get the proper meaning of sentence, you need to go for semantics of propositional logic. These are the important topics which we discuss in the first lecture. In the next lecture, we will discuss about precedence of operators, converting the sentences into the form of propositional logic, and then we discuss about what are truth tables, how do we construct a truth table for each logical connectivity. Thank you very much.